us, right? You're able to observe it. So once you realize who you are, what you gotta do? Step on this side and teach your people. The kingdom of God is within you. You. Once you wake up and teach your people, the kingdom will come. No more do we have to get gunned down. No more do women have to be raped. No more do we have to hate each other. Y'all gotta see that. Stop saying, I want change. Do it. Everybody ain't gonna make it, brother. One third of our people will make it. Two-thirds will perish here in Babylon.
We're gonna tell you nothing different, since we are the prophets of the Most High. We're not gonna tell you what you wanna hear. We don't speak smooth words.
Right.
We're not gonna prophesy blessings.
Right.
We're gonna tell you, thus saith the Lord.
That's right.
And that is that if you don't repent, death is coming.
Right.
Read that.
Isaiah 29:13. I know you never heard this before, right? Because guess what? You have been taught this Bible by your brother.
That's right.
But guess what? In these last days, God is waking up the true men of God teach his people and bring us back into repentance.
Right.
Because you are the Israelites. You are the chosen people of God. Read.
So thy race.
Read. Which thou leavest shall be magnified.
So our race will be magnified.
That's right.
Race is in the Bible, brother.
That's right.
God is a racist.
Answer.
Read that again.
Somewhere in West Africa. That's as far as I got.
But Israel does not know.
That's you. You don't know.
I do know.
You don't. That's why you can't give me an answer.
I don't have to.
You know why you can't give me an answer?
Because
you don't
personally
know.
Read. My people does not consider
in a hospital.
Our sinful nation.
Our sinful nation. That's you right now, brother. You think you know something, but you don't know anything.
That's right.
So it's time for you to wake up. We're trying to show you in the Bible. Give me a scripture to go through to show me your nationality. I will shut my mouth right now if you can give me a scripture.
I don't have to.
Because you don't have one.
I don't need
you. You don't have a scripture. Admit it. Be a man and say, sir, I just don't know.
I don't
know. Our people come out here, when they see the prophets of the Lord, they got something to say. Hold on, I'm talking. They got something to say. They feel like they have a pedestal to sit on and to speak like they know God,
right.
Like they know the Lord. You have no Bible and no understanding of the Word of God.
That's
so
right.
When the promise of the Lord come before you, it's time to listen.
Right.
Read on.
But you asked the question.
All sinful nations,
read,
and people laden with iniquity, and sin of evildoers.
What?
And seed of evildoers.
Come on.
Children that are corrupt.
Children that are what?
Our corruptor.
We run around thinking that we know something. We have worldly knowledge, worldly understanding. The brother asked you about, can you just get up and leave right now? You think that you're not being oppressed or you're not a slave. You are. The law still says you are. You realize if they eradicated the 14th Amendment, you know what would happen to you and me and all your people? Back to slavery, brother.
Bring it out.
Straight back to slavery. Did you know that? The law has been written and shown that we are not the same as everyone else. That's why we need a 14th Amendment.
Right.
We're not the same.
Right.
So what we're trying to show you, brother, the Bible brought that out. The Bible told us we would be slaves in a land.
All I can say is,
read on. You don't
God
need to say anything.
Now, well, listen. I believe that God deals with me in the spirit.
This is
he don't
what we gotta understand.
In the flesh.
You
he
can't
turns
believe
back
that.
On me. And
you truly
heart,
can't believe
man,
that.
That's all I
Ecclesiastes 5:1.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 1.
Read.
Keep thy foot.
Do what?
Keep thy foot.
The Bible, the word says keep your foot.
Read. When thou goest to the house of God.
That's what needs to happen when you come before the prophets of God.
That's right.
Watch your step.
That's right.
That's right.
The men of the Lord are here to teach you and to guide you in the word of the Most High God. There's no room for you to be talking. We don't need to hear your commentary on what you think or your belief. He said, my belief, the Bible don't speak like that, so we don't.
That's right.
The Bible says what it says. Keep your foot, read.
And be more ready to hear.
Do what?
Be more ready to hear.
Come on.
Than to give sacrifice of fools.
Give a sacrifice of fools. You sound like an idiot up here.
That's right.
It'd have been easier for you to just listen, keep quiet, and learn.
That's right.
But our people think they know something.
So these are consequences. These are the consequences. That's why we're in slavery today, bro. Listen up. You too, bro. What's your name? Hey, listen up. Hey, you a pastor? All right, listen up. Do you ever teach this to your people? Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Read.
But it shall come to pass.
Read.
If thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments,
right,
and his statutes. Ten Commandments this day.
So if we didn't keep God's commandments, right? We're going to see what happened to the... Let us finish up real quick. Read that.
There are all these curses.
All these curses. What's a curse, brother? Brother, that says he's a pastor. What's a curse? What's the definition of curse? Is it something good or something bad? Something bad, right? Reese?
That all these curses shall come upon me and overtake me.
So that's why we're in this condition.
Who church is this?
Hey, brother, you got any questions?
My thing is, do y'all follow all the Ten Commandments?
We follow all the Ten Commandments.
I'm gone, man. I'm gone.
You say this
ain't no scam or nothing.
No, this ain't no scam. This is the truth right here. We're going to show you right now. We're coming out the Bible.
Bring it out.
I'm not just lip service. Right? Exodus chapter 24, verse 12. Hey, brother, you had a question. Right? Here's the question. Read.
And the Lord said unto Moses,
right?
Come up to me into the mount,
right?
And be there, and I will give thee tables of stone.
Right? Now we're going to see what them tables of stones are, read.
And a law.
A law, read.
And commandments.
And commandments. So there was more than 10 commandments. There was laws, right?
Bring it on.
So do you know what law you're breaking right now? What's up?
This is what I asked.
No, hey, I can't hear you, bro. Come forward.
Nah, don't put me on camera, but I don't want to be on y'all.
Check the fire.
No, it's just...
Check the fire.
Don't worry about the camera, bro. There's cameras around here, and you don't tell them nothing.
Right.
What? What?
I'm asking you, do you follow all 10 commandments?
Do I follow all 10 commandments? Let's read that.
What about you?
Oh, yeah, I follow God's commandments.
What day do y'all go to church?
What day we go to church? This is church right here.
Yes, sir.
Give me that next real quick.
Get out.
That's what they've been taught us. Give me Isaiah 29:13 real quick.
Bring it up.
Cause look, the philosophy you got, bruh, is for your slave master.
Alright? Right.
That's why you say what church you go to.
Bring it up!
Right? Listen up, bruh. Read.
Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13.
Read.
Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth.
That's what our people do, right? We draw near to God. Oh, Christ is, and I love God, right? Read.
And with their lips do honor me.
Right?
But have removed their hearts far from me.
But we removed our mind far from God's commandments.
Yeah,
right? Not just the 10, all 600 plus commandments.
Read. Right?
And their fear toward me.
Listen up, bro, listen. That's the scripture's coming out.
And their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men.
So the fear towards God of the understanding of this Bible is taught by the precept of men. Now who is those precept of men? Yes, the so-called white men. They taught you the Bible. That's why we don't have no understanding. Now I'm going to show you the church. You said what church we go. Read that.
Acts chapter 7, verse 38.
This is the church right here, bro. Listen up. Read.
This is he that was in the church in the wilderness.
Hey, listen up, bro. What you say? You said that the 12 tribes are not in the Bible?
12 tribes,
Judah. Not Israel. Oh, so what you're saying, this is wrong right here. What? It's not called the 12 tribes of Israel.
Hey,
brother, don't run. All right? Stand bold for your questions. Read that.
James chapter 1, verse 1.
Do you believe in an Old Testament?
I believe in the Holy Bible.
And the whole Bible, right? Read.
James, a servant of God.
Right.
And of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
To the 12 tribes.
To the 12 tribes that what?
Which are scattered abroad.
Who are scattered abroad, bro? When you read the book of Genesis, it tells you the sons of Jacob, which are the 12 tribes of Israel. All right?
That's right.
Hey, brothers, you got any questions?
No, sir. I know about it.
So, do you believe in God?
I believe in Heavenly Father.
So you get
it. I believe in the Most High.
All right, so do you know who God is?
Because you know who God is.
You got to know who God is to really say,
do you know who God is?
I know who God is.
You tell me who God is.
All right, give me that. Give me 6:3. We're going to show you who God is.
All right, show me.
Who's this right here? You see that devil in the corner right here?
Where he at?
Right there.
Uh-huh.
Is that your Jesus?
No. I believe his feet was bronze.
All right.
His eye was red, and his hair was like wool.
So he looked
close. You give me the description of that.
Right.
He looked closer to this right here.
That's
in Revelations, right?
Hey, brother, does this look closer?
Yes, it does.
All right.
I just said his feet like bronze.
All right, I'm going to show you who God is. the God that you see
show,
among
us. Tell me.
Look, I'm going to show you the God. The
give it to me here.
Worship.
Give it to me. Exodus chapter 15, verse 3.
Read.
The Lord is a man of war.
No, he just loves the kisses.
The Lord is a man of war.
So our God is a man of war.
Yes. Yes. He is.
He, ordained he ain't no soft person.
He ordained
that
war.
Right now.
He ordained war.
Now, do you know how to worship God now?
Oh, yeah.
How do you worship him?
What you mean, how do I worship? I pray to him.
Oh, but how?
What you mean?
Bring it out. You said.
Tell me. You tell me. What? How do you worship?
I'm sure
I bow down to him.
Give me that.
I bow down to the Most High. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to ask you a question. If you stay here.
Yeah, I got to get
so I'm about to show you, bro, how to worship God. Yeah.
I'm listening.
Give me that. I'm going to show you how to love God, bro.
I'm listening.
There's a lot of people, we live service. We go to church Sunday. You going to church Sunday?
I don't go to church on Sunday. He's with me.
He's with you, right? Yeah. So you're out of church, okay?
The kingdom of heaven is in with me.
Right, you right. But we're going to get more understanding on that. Read that.
First John, chapter 2, verse 3.
So, hey, this is how you love God, bro. According to the Bible. Not what we say. Read.
That's right. And hereby, we do know that we know him.
So, if you know God, right? Read.
If we keep his commandments.
So, if you know God, you must be keeping his commandments.
That's right.
You can't just say, oh, I know God. God is... It is me.
What is his commandments?
Read that. What is his commandments?
Yeah, good question. Tell me what's his commandments.
All right, read that.
Verse 4. He that saith I know him,
right,
and keepeth not his commandments is a liar.
So if you said, do you keep God's commandments?
Yes.
You're a liar. Read that again.
The truth is not in him.
So the truth is not in you, bro.
That's
so you're a liar. You need to repent for that, bro. You said I give you a commandment. Give me the beard or the fridge, whichever way. I'm going to show you. All
right,
the commandment.
Get out.
Must be keeping.
Numbers chapter 15, verse 38.
Read.
Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them.
You keep them moving. Read.
That's right. And bid them that they make them fringes.
You make them fringes. You know what fringes is?
Now give it to me.
Fringes is what you see on the board.
What
look.
You got on right here. Right.
Those are fringes,
okay,
right?
Okay.
We're going to see what's. Why we have to wear fringes, right?
Yes, in the borders of their garment,
right?
Throughout their generation.
No, sometimes.
Throughout their generation.
So throughout your generation, the generation. Don't stop, bro.
That's right. And then ye put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
That's why you see brothers here with the ribbon of blue.
That's
the only time we don't wear fringes when we shower, bro. But other than that, we wear fringes 24/7, right?
That's right.
Bro.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe.
Right, it should be on you for a fringe, read.
That ye may look upon it.
So we look upon these fringes, read.
And remember all the commandments of the Lord.
Read that again.
And remember
and
all.
And remember all the commandments, read.
Of the Lord and do them.
And do them. So we just don't think about it. Talk about it. We got to do it.
That's right.
That's keeping it. That's a commandment that you're breaking, bro. But it's all right. Our people been... Are people in
okay, slavery? You told me that I'm breaking a commandment.
Yeah, that's the commandment.
I still don't understand what commandment I have I broke.
This one with the fringes.
Oh, because I don't have fringes, I'm breaking a commandment?
Yes, exactly. And give me John 9:31. Because you said you pray to the Lord, right?
We're
going to give you the understanding.
Bring it up.
John 9:31. All right? Let's bring it out. Because guess what? A lot of our people have faith in the Most High, but they don't really what? Worship him through their actions.
Right.
Your everyday life should show your faith. Your That's faith right. should be declared by your works.
That's right. Right.
John chapter 9, verse 31.
Read.
Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
What is sin?
We do not follow God's commandments.
Right, exactly. When you break God's commandments, that's a sin. So God what? Now.
Okay. Now we know that God hear not sinners.
Read.
But if any man be a worshiper of God and doeth his will,
and you do his commandments,
him he hears.
So if you pray to the Lord and you in the midst of sin, guess what? The Lord is not hearing it.
That's right.
Give me Luke 6:46.
I'm going
to show you what this Bible is talking about, brother. We out here to edify you.
Okay,
hold on, brother. Because you came out here running your mouth, brother. So it's time for you to humble down and listen to the word of God.
Read Luke chapter 6, verse 46.
This is the black man in America today. Read.
And why call ye me Lord, Lord?
Huh?
And why call ye me Lord, Lord?
Read.
And do not the things that I say.
Why you claim you believe in the Bible and the Lord, but you don't do nothing this Bible says? You believe in the Lord and you got a marijuana symbol on your hat?
Let's read.
Hold on.
That is
in Genesis. God uprooted everything. Everything was right and good.
Now ye know that you are the temple of God.
Bring it out.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
Come on.
And if any man defile the temple of God,
if any man defile his temple by what? Ingesting drugs,
right.
Marijuana,
right.
Crack, cocaine.
Come on.
Him shall God destroy.
God's gonna do what?
Him shall God destroy.
That's no, God's right. gonna bless him.
Him shall God destroy.
So God said we can smoke weed. God said we can smoke weed.
He uprooted everything. He uprooted.
He uprooted.
We can smoke
he,
weed.
He uprooted. No.
Did he uproot it?
God yes. said
Hold
we can smoke weed.
Yes
or no?
Okay, in Genesis, did he say he uprooted?
Hey, somebody give me, give this brother the Bible. Give this brother the Bible. Show me in the Bible what you're talking about. We're going to give you a chance. Show me in the Bible what you're talking about. Now, while he's giving me that, give me Proverbs.
Yeah, that's right.
Give me Proverbs, or do I want verse 9? Yeah, I think I want verse 9.
Too much for time.
Yeah, okay, we're going to see.
I just don't believe that, man. Go ahead.
Make sure y'all get this man on camera looking for that scripture. All right? Give me Proverbs 28, verse 9.
Psalms 104:14.
Proverbs chapter 28, verse 9.
Huh?
He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, if you turn your ears away from hearing God's laws, even his prayer shall be an abomination.
Your prayer is an abomination before the Lord. Now give me 1 Corinthians 11. Give me the covering his head while he's prophesying. Give me that.
1 Corinthians, because this brother going through the scriptures, he looking in the Bible, he got his head covered. This is in Christ. Read. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3.
What the Bible says.
But I will have you know that the head of every man.
Hey. Hold on.
Hold on.
We're going to get your scripture, but watch this.
And the head of Christ is God.
And the head of Christ is God. Come on.
Verse 4, every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered,
every man praying with a weed hat on,
dishonoreth his head.
Dishonoreth Christ. See, according to the scriptures, and guess what? You got a head covered on, dishonoring Christ.
How am I dishonoring Christ with God? With
he uprooted everything, though.
Hold on a second.
He uprooted everything, though, my brother. Can I read it
now?
Okay. First, Genesis 29, it said, and God said, behold, I said, giving you herb, being seed, which upon the face of all earth, and every tree, and which is fruit of the tree, yield seed, to it should be meat.
Okay, so meat, what does that mean? Is meat smoking?
Say what?
Are you smoking it, or are you eating it?
I'm still consuming it.
I'm consuming it.
I know it's not good.
Huh?
But I know it's not good.
I'm standing in
okay.
Nah,
so it's not good.
Ain't nothing wrong with her.
He's busy right now.
Come back later.
I live my life.
Say, no.
Yes, sir.
If you could ask me a question.
It was with Genesis, right?
Yes, sir.
Where God talks about all, he gave herbs for good, for all things, right?
Yes, sir.
Now,
that's right.
We just talked about poison ivy. We know you ain't gonna eat poison ivy.
Uh-huh.
We ain't gonna eat
right.
poison ivy,
no.
Right? But you choose to smoke marijuana, right? Because it hallucinates your mind and makes you feel good, right? So let's see what the Bible says when it talks about herbs. Let's go further into dealing with herbs.
Get this verse.
Don't walk away now.
Chapter 104, verse 14.
Read.
He causes the grass to grow for the cattle.
He does what?
He causes the grass to grow for the cattle.
He causes the grass to grow for the cattle so the cows can eat, so the cows can have something to eat.
Read. And herbs for the service of men.
But herbs for the service of men.
Right.
For the what?
An herb for the service of man.
For the service of man.
Read on. That he may bring forth food out of the earth.
Oh! I thought we were smoking it.
That he may bring forth food out of the earth.
I like basil. I like mint.
Right.
I like parsley.
Right.
Read.
That he may bring forth food out of the earth.
I like rosemary on my chicken.
Right.
But the Bible doesn't give me a green light to take the herb and smoke it up.
So
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.